Hello friends, myself Maitri Dave, and today we are going to understand different types and factors affecting the roof covering. So let us start with today's lecture where we first see which are the factors which affect to select different types of roof covering, right? So following factors should be considered before selecting the type of roof covering for a pitch roof particularly. The first one is the climate of the locality. Then the fabrication facilities, nature of the building, type of roof framework, initial cost and the maintenance cost, resistance to fire and heat, durability, special features of the locality and the availability of material. So these all are the factors which are affecting while we are selecting a particular type of roof covering, right? Now let us see the different types of roof covering first. Here the first one is the thatch, then the ordinary half round country tiles, then the shingles, patent tiles, Trafford asbestos cement tiles, Eternit slates, corrugated galvanized iron sheets, asbestos cement corrugated sheets, and lastly the rubroid. So let us understand all one by one. First one is the thatch. It means this is a very light roof covering, but it is combustible, absorbs moisture rapidly, and is easily liable to decay. It is unstable against the high winds. A bed of matting is prepared to receive the thatch and in order to drain the roof easily. A pitch of 45 degree is kept. The thatch is usually used in the rural areas because it is the cheapest form of roof covering and it is the simple in the construction. Here you can see a clear image of a thatch. Now let us move to the second type, which is the ordinary half round country tiles. So these are used for cheap buildings. If tiles are laid in two layers, the roof is known as the double tile roof. An overlap of at least 80 mm should be provided when these tiles are used. These tiles are liable to break easily and hence they require frequent replacement. Here you can see a clear image of this kind of tiles. Now let us move to the third one, which is shingles. So the wood shingles are obtained from the well-seasoned timbers with lengths varying from 300 mm to 380 mm and widths varying from 60 mm to 250 mm. They are laid in a similar fashion as tiles and the slats. This roof covering is found to be useful especially in hilly areas where the wood is the easily and cheaply available material. Here you can see a clear image of these shingles. Next is the patent tiles. So the various patent tiles are available which can be used as a roof covering. The Mangalore tiles can be one of such patent tiles. They are red in color and made of double channeled basal mason Mangalore pattern. The special Mangalore tiles are also available for the rich. It is found that about 15 Mangalore tiles are required for covering 1 square meter of a roof area. Here you can see a clear image of this kind of tiles. Now let us move to the next one, which is Trafford asbestos cement tiles. So these are made of cement and asbestos. They possess less corrugation and are laid with the laps of 150 mm and 100 mm at the ends and at the sides respectively. Here you can see a clear image of it. Next is the Eternit slates. So these are the fire resistant, or we can say light and cool as well. They are not easily affected by the weather. That is the plus point. About 8 slates are required 3 square meter of roof area. The Eternit slates are generally available in 3 colors: gray, black, and the red. Here you can see a clear image of these slates. Next is the corrugated galvanized iron steel. These are prepared by pressing flat wrought iron plates between rollers with grooves or teeth and then they are galvanized with a coat of zinc. These sheets are commonly known as GI sheets. The process of galvanizing is named after the 18th century Italian scientist Galvani, and it has been perfected to highly sophisticated degree, achieving improvement in quality, economy, productivity and labor savings. The use of computer-controlled sophisticated modern equipment ensures a quality product with a uniform, tightly adherent layer of zinc. The corrugations help to increase the strength and rigidity, and they permit easy flow of rainwater. They are available in the lengths varying from 1.20 meter to 3.60 meter and in widths varying from 600 to 900 mm. The thickness varies from 0.18 mm to 1.60 mm and they are costly and do not offer resistance to fire and sound. So that's it for the corrugated sheets. Now let us understand the asbestos cement corrugated sheets. So the cement is mixed with about 15% of asbestos fibers, and the paste is so formed is pressed under the rollers with grooves or the teeth. Thus the sheets commonly known as the AC sheets with a series of waves or corrugations are formed, and they are used for factories, workshop, garages, big halls, etc. The corrugations help to increase strength and rigidity, and they permit the easy flow of rainwater. They are available under different trade names such as big six sheets, standard sheets, Trafford sheets, etc. in standard sizes. They are cheap, fire resisting, light in weight, strong, tough, soundproof, impervious and durable. They do not require any productive paint and cannot be eaten away by the vermins. These sheets can be shown and screwed. Some of the points that one should be noted in connecting with fixing of this asbestos cement sheet. The first one says the sheet should be laid with smooth side upward and the end marked top pointing towards the edge. The sheets are usually laid with an end lap of 150 mm. But this lap can be slightly adjusted to suit the spacing of pawlings. The pawling spacing and the length of sheet should be properly checked before the processes of laying starts. The holes for fixing the accessories must be drilled and not punched in the crown of corrugations. The diameter of the hole should be 3 mm greater than the diameter of screws or bolt to be used, and a bituminous washer must be provided under this GI flat washer with each bolt or screw. Now the sheet should be properly metered or cut to avoid gaps where four sheets meet at length. The nuts of the screws or bolts are moderately tightened when 10 to 12 sheets have been laid, and the screws or bolts on the pawlings are not tightened very tight. The ridge capping should be preferably screwed to the ridge pawling by the same kind of bolt which are used for fixing the sheets. And the unsupported length of the overhang at the eaves of the sheets should not exceed 300 mm. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understand different types, right? See you soon in the next lecture.